Thank you, Durward. Nice of you and Gary to leave us all this nice, fresh air for broadcasting.
Said they had a good show, didn't they?
Always a good show. Could I sing now?
That's a good idea.
You sinners, drop everything. Let that harmony ring up to heaven and sing. Sing, you sinners. Just wave your arms all about. Let the Lord hear you shout. Pour that music right out. Sing, you sinners. Whenever that music the devil kicks, he don't allow music by the river Styx. You're wicked and you're depraved, and you all misbehave. If you want to be saved, sing, you sinners.
Limerick today.
Well, you're on, kid. Take your best shot.
There was a young mother named May who welcomed her kids home from play with Sara Lee cake for a cool summer break. No wonder they run all away.
Goody.
You like it?
Goody, goody gumdrop.
Uh-huh.
And here's another version, special for the ladies. There was a young wife named Gay who pampered her husband each day with Sara Lee cake for a cool summer break. She got her new mink coat right away.
Hey, that might work, especially with Sara Lee cream cheesecake. It's a favorite with most men.
What makes it taste so special, Rosie?
Sara Lee skill, and because it's made with the freshest real cream cheese and other fine ingredients.
You know what I like? I like that crunchy graham cracker crust.
And that special surprise topping.
You're making me so hungry.
With Sara Lee cream cheesecake, you can enjoy really delicious cream cheesecake as often as you want, oven fresh from your freezer. Like all Sara Lee cakes, it's completely baked, ready to serve and enjoy. Merrily, merrily, only Sara Lee tastes so good.
Well, here's an evergreen now, one that I've always had a fondness for. This is from Connecticut Yankee, so you'll notice the poetic pronoun. Thou swell, thou witty, thou sweet, thou grand, wouldst kiss me pretty. Wouldst hold my hand, both thine eyes are cute too, what they do to me. Hear me holler, I choose a sweet Lollapalooza in thee. I'd feel so rich in a hut for two, two rooms and kitchen, I'm sure would do. Give me just a plot of not a lot of land. And thou swell, thou witty, thou grand. Two rooms
rooms and the kitchen, I'm sure would do. Give me just a plot of not a lot of land, and thou swell, thou witty, thou grand.
Say, you remember that wedding day situation we were talking about where so many males fainted in comparison to the females? Remember that discussion?
Sure. The figures were 3-1, weren't they, on fainting?
That's the ratio. Men pass out 3-1. Look at that.
Well, you know, I think I'd like to explore this topic a little further. I'd like to continue it.
You better drop it, Bing. Just forget it. The odds are apt to go 4-1 any minute.
We may have to close the polls.
Oh, the book is folding, huh? I feel we should research this a little. I honestly do. Let us sort of indulge in a little fact-finding here.
For that, you mean the underlying principles of
now,
the thing, huh?
What I want to know is, what are some of the elements that cause a man to cave in when he's going to the altar? What are the reasons for his strange behavior?
Well, I'll tell you one. The reason that a lot of men faint before they get married is that they're just plain scared to death.
Well, I'm surprised a member of the female sex would admit that.
We're not scared.
No, but you're the reason men are scared.
Not at all.
Oh, Bing, I believe that a fellow's scared to death because, well, he has a sort of a feeling that he's a cornered animal, a trapped animal. He says to himself, this is it.
And he blacks out.
There you go.
It's a moment of truth.
But just one second. What about that poor little girl that's being trapped? It's the moment of truth for her, too.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Let's stick to the man. It's the man who faints the most often. Remember, 3-1. I guess he figures he can't run, he can't fly, he has no wings, he can't scream. That would be a little crazy. So what does he do? He faints.
Yeah, it's a form of release, really.
Exactly the way I figure. He gets a few more seconds to be alone with himself. Even though he's in a coma. He's all in there, but he pull his little coma in with him.
He reprieves himself.
Yeah.
Well, babe, we might as well face it. Weddings are not for the weak-kneed. And that's what a lot of you fellas are.
So the old saying holds true, huh? Faint heart ne'er won fair lady?
But that's no sign fair lady never won faint heart, you know.
Aw, Bing, now come off it. We women don't chase the men half as much as you wish we did.
The way I see it, Rosie, isn't it the men object to being chased or pursued? It's when they're caught that they fall into a heap.
Maybe men are allergic to orange blossoms.
Yeah, or shotgun smoke.
Well, whatever the reasons, I think we've covered them pretty thoroughly, but it certainly points up one thing adequately, and that's that men are actually, after all, they are the emotional sex.
I don't know about you, Bing, but I'm all shook up over this.
Pull yourselves together, boys. You're running out of fingernails.
I have an idea. Maybe we can get Buddy Cole to play the wedding march.
What do you want to do? Have men fainting from coast to coast here? Let's have a song that's not going to shatter men's nerves. Let's have some easy, cool music.
What is there to say? And what is there to do? The dream I've been seeking has, practically speaking, come true. What is there to say? And how will I pull through? I knew in a moment contentment and home meant just you. You are so lovable, so livable. Your charm is just so unforgivable. You're made to marvel at, and words to that effect. What is there to say? And what is there to do? My heart's in a deadlock. I'd even face wedlock with you. Thank you.
you were just kidding when you said men were really the emotional sex, weren't you?
No, no, I wasn't at all. I think it's a most alarming situation that so many men faint at weddings. To me, that proves conclusively we've become the emotional sex.
Okay, you win the title.
Well, I personally think there's no doubt about the fact that we're the frail ones, the delicate ones.
You're hysterical.
And for that reason, that don't you think that women ought to do an about-face with us and... Well, see that we're more protected and catered to.
You're darn tootin'. That's the only course, really, for the ladies to take.
How you boys dream it up.
I think that women should help their gentlemen friends. They should open car doors, help us in and out, give us a little service.
Yes, ladies, start treating us like we've been treating you.
Hmm? Like you've been treating us? How long is it since you saw a man open a car door for a woman?
Well, we're too delicate.
Oh.
Too sensitive for that kind of work.
Oh, heavy.
Heavy opening car doors.
Yes.
Sure, it's a woman's job.
Yes, that's what we've been trying to tell you.
And another thing, I think that the ladies should give men seats on buses and subways and on the suburban trains, too. Ladies, get up and give the poor man your seat.
Yes, relinquish your cane bottom to a poor, high-strung, emotional man.
Oh, brother.
And another thing, wait a minute, ladies.
Brother.
It's really important that you cuddle us and make things easy for us. The weather's warm.
Because during hot weather, we're apt to faint right in our tracks.
If we don't get a seat.
Lay there.
We're not getting much sympathy here. Oh,
well, maybe out in the homes where the ladies are listening, we're drumming up a little sentiment for the cause.
Well, I hope so.
As long as we're on this subject, Bing, I have one more little suggestion.
And?
Well, I think the ladies should remember us when they come home from shopping.
Yeah.
You know, bring us a little box of candy or maybe a bunch of violets.
Yeah, some little bauble.
Mm.
Even if it's only a little bottle of shaving oil. We do love to open presents, don't we,
Kat? Oh, we sure do.
Just love to rip their
ribbon. It's not the gift so much, Bing. It shows that the girls are thinking of us. That's really what it is.
Of course, we don't want to acquire anything worldly. It's not that at all. We just want sweet thoughts. Thoughts in the form of gift-wrapped packages.
Oh, and Bing, don't forget, diamonds are a boy's best friend.
I was working up to that. I was leading that way.
I'm not trying to dishearten or disillusion you boys. But don't hold your breath, either one of you, until the ladies in your life start bringing you presents or opening car doors for you.
We shouldn't hold our breath,
no.
Huh?
That's a way to faint for sure.
Well, why don't we try to revive Buddy Cole in the orchestra now? Throw a bucket of ice water on Buddy over there, will you, somebody? Let's get going here with a song.
Honeybee fills with jealousy when they see you out with me. I don't blame them, goodness knows. Honeysuckle rose. When you're passing by, flowers droop and sigh, and I know the reason why. You're much sweeter, goodness knows. Honeysuckle rose. Well, I don't buy sugar, you just have to touch my cup. You're my sugar, so sweet when you stir it up. When I'm taking sips from your tasty lips, seems the honey fairly drips. Your confection, goodness knows, honeysuckle rose. Honeysuckle rose.
A very important love song now, ladies and gentlemen.
And what makes this particular love song so important, Bing?
Well, I tell you, we rehearsed it, we know it, and yeah. Buddy Cole's got the downbeat standing by there.
Wait till I get a glass of water.
Later. Women, women.
They say that falling in love is wonderful. It's wonderful. So they say.
And with the moon up above, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. So they tell me.
I can't recall who said it. I know I never read it.
I only know they tell me that love is grand. And
to hold a girl in your arms is one. Wonderful, wonderful, in every way, so they say.
You'll find that falling in love is wonderful. It's wonderful. So they say.
And with the moon up above, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. So they tell me.
So we conclude for now. We hope you enjoyed what we had to sing for you and what we had to say.
Hope also you'll be listening again tomorrow. Same time, same place.
As Mrs. Phineas Teakworthy Barnaby said to her daughter Pamela, there's no sense in doing something halfway when without any more effort you can do it right. Oh, brilliantly put, Mrs. Barnaby. She was, as you may or may not have guessed, referring to expanded CBS News over the CBS Radio Network, the most complete network news service in broadcasting today. Get all of the news from where it happens every hour weekdays right here.